Hi guys, good evening. All right, good evening everyone. Welcome to the India's largest online learning platform, that is GradeUp, and welcome to the fresh class of control systems where we're going to discuss the compensators topic. Yes, very, very good evening, all my dear students. So yesterday we discussed about the controllers. That was the last class, and today we'll continue our discussion on the discussion of compensators, right? Yes, good evening all, good evening everyone. So before I start off with compensators, as always, this is the introduction about me. Rakesh Talreja, secured All India rank 9th in the GATE examination and completed my master's from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. So before I start off the compensators, I'll give you one very, very, very simple numerical from the yesterday's portion. Already for the controllers also we solved the numericals yesterday anyways. Now moving forward with one simple numericals. Okay. Can you give me very quickly the answer for this? Okay. Then we'll move towards compensators gradually. For the following systems, design a suitable proportional controller. One of the simplest controller I'm talking about. And why only I'm talking about proportional controller? Because my intention is to reduce the error. Okay. Yes, Saurabh, any doubt from previous class, you can ask in the doubt box separately. Yes, guys, can you answer this very quickly? Just logically, no need to solve it. Just logically remember what I have told yesterday by the knowledge of that. Yes, Ramya, absolutely correct. Yes, Girish Reddy and Gajendra, correct answer. Can we answer this in a very short moment? Yes, Pritam and Likhita, correct answer. All right. So yesterday I told you one fact about the proportional controller. It is the main. It is mainly used only for the steady state error. When it talks about steady state error, it has some disadvantages also. That is why we commonly use it with the D controller, PD controller, or the PI controller. So what is one important thing that I told you? That steady state error is proportional to 1 by Kp. That means inversely proportional to Kp. Okay. Here they are asking you to reduce the error by 3 times. Okay, to reduce the steady state error by 3 times, matlab 1/3, make Kp equal to 3. That is the answer. Now, why I am asking you this simple question? If Kp is equal to 3, guys, for Kp equal to 3, now what will be the characteristic equation of the system? Okay, it is actually 1 plus, these two blocks are in cascade. So multiply the gain. So overall GS is 3Kp divided by S plus 1, S plus 2 equal to 0. So it is going to turn up as S cube plus 3S square plus 2S plus 3Kp equal to 0. Let Kp be equal to Kp right now. Then I will put it ultimately. Okay. And then I make the Routh array, that is 1, 2, 3 and 3Kp. So what is S raised to the power 1 row will become 6 minus 3Kp divided by 6, last element 0. S raised to the power 0. S raised to the power 0 is 3Kp and 0. Kp is anyways positive. Okay. So, under the condition Kp equal to 3, if I substitute here, I get what? 3 minus 3 into 3, that is 9. 3 minus 9 minus 3 divided by 3 is minus 1. The value of this element is minus 1. And because the value of this element is minus 1, so I have plus 2 minus a sign change. Minus 2 plus another sign change. Alright, so for Kp equal to 3, we have a system that is converted to unstable system. That is, if I take Kp equal to 1, guys, then it is stable. Matlab, if I don't introduce the proportionality gain, Kp equal to 1 means what? ठीक है, यू ऑल नो दिस इज द गेन ऑफ द कंट्रोलर फ्रॉम द लास्ट क्लास. तो इफ आई डायरेक्टली कनेक्ट द एरर सिग्नल टू द फॉरवर्ड पाथ गेन, दैट मींस केपी इज इक्वल टू 1. अंडर दैट केस द सिस्टम इज स्टेबल. सो विदाउट द कंट्रोलर सिस्टम वॉज स्टेबल. एक्चुअली इफ आई से हियर, लुकिंग फ्रॉम द राउथ अरे यू कैन कंक्लूड दैट 6 माइनस 3 केपी शुड बी पॉजिटिव फॉर नो साइन चेंज. दैट मीन्स द रेंज ऑफ केपी, ठीक है, शुड बी फ्रॉम 0 टू 2. The range of KP from 0 to 2, and you have taken a value of KP equal to 3, okay, which satisfies the error, which satisfies the accuracy what you want, but the system has been converted to unstable. So now please kindly comment and kindly tell me, is there any use of such a system now? Okay, you have achieved your accuracy, you have reduced the error to 1/3, but is there any use of such system? Do you find such system will be useful for you? Yes, guys, can you just comment on this? Obviously no, because the system is converted of unstable, that's practically of no use. Okay, so when we talk about controllers, so you know, we are talking about some parameters like speed. Yesterday we have seen about speed calculations, the calculations about accuracy like this one, or we talk about what we talk about the transient performance like overshoot of the system. Okay, so we have certain parameters in hand which we want to control, which we want to design. But what happens sometimes while designing those parameters, you may convert, you may end up into an unstable system. Now what to do? There are two options. What to do now? There are two options. As the system is unstable, the number one possibility, throw away the system. Just spoil the system. Okay, it is of no use. Okay. Or number two possibility, rather than just throwing away your system, number two possibility is some loss has occurred to your system, compensate for the loss of stability. Earlier it was stable, but now you have converted into unstable. So can you compensate for the loss of stability? Yes, we may try to compensate into the loss of stability by using appropriate compensators. Okay, that's what I want to mention here. Ki suppose we have designed a controller to achieve a desired performance of the control system, but this might affect the stability of the system, and hence compensators are introduced in the runtime to compensate for the loss of stability. By runtime, what I mean, what is the concept of runtime? That means you are not designing a system from scratch. As I told, don't throw away the system. You have a already pre-designed system. Okay, so in the runtime, matlab the system has been designed, it is working, but it is not stable, it has some loss. To compensate for the loss, you do the modifications in the already designed system. Okay, so when you are doing the modification in the already designed system, that is known as the runtime. Okay, in the runtime, not from the basic, not from the scratch, but in the already constructed system, some changes we need to introduce. Okay, those changes are known as compensators. These compensators will introduce a pole and zero in that transfer function, which will be affecting the stability of the system. The compensators will introduce a pole and zero in the transfer function that will be responsible for affecting the stability of the system. Okay, so like controllers, compensators are also of two kinds, the forward path compensators and the feedback path compensator, based on where the compensator element has been used, whether it is in cascade with GS or whether it is in cascade with HS. Accordingly, it is classified as forward path or feedback path. According to your syllabus of engineering services or gate examination for both, you only have to deal with the forward path compensator, and you are going to learn about three forward path compensators today. Okay, what are these three forward path compensators? Number one is the phase lead. I will hide my view. Phase lag and phase lead lag compensator. These are the three compensators that you are going to discuss in the forward path compensators. All right. Okay. Feedback path compensators are also there, but that is not part of your syllabus. Just I'm telling you, when the GCS is in cascade with H, that is known as the feedback path compensator, right? Now starting with the phase lead compensator, the first one. The phase lead compensator. Kindly take the screenshot up to this part, the basics part, and then we start with the phase lead compensator immediately. Yeah. Take the screenshots quickly. नेक्स्ट वन, नेक्स्ट वन, नेक्स्ट स्क्रीनशॉट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द नीड ऑफ द कंपनसेटर एंड नाउ वी विल सी द डिजाइन ऑफ द कंपनसेटर. नेक्स्ट स्क्रीनशॉट, ओके चलिए. ओके गाइस, सो नाउ कम बैक टू द स्क्रीन वेयर वी स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट वन, फेस लीड कंपनसेटर. इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द डेरिवेशन ऑफ वन, सेकंड विल बी डन सिमिलरली, नॉट अ बिग डील इन दैट. सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फेस लीड कंपनसेटर गाइस, अ फेस लीड कंपनसेटर, फर्स्ट आई इंट्रोड्यूस द टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसफर फंक्शन रिक्वायर्ड एंड एन एग्जांपल, अ प्रैक्टिकल एग्जांपल व्हिच कैन रिप्रेजेंट एज अ लीड कंपनसेटर. ओके, अ फेस लीड कंपनसेटर हैज द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन ऑफ द फॉर्म एस प्लस जेड डिवाइडेड बाय एस प्लस पी. ओके, yes Ratha Ramon, no it's not lead lag, we are starting with lead compensator first of all, it is just a lead lag compensator. Yes, good evening Sarthak. Yes everyone, try to follow time, it's beneficial for you only. Yeah, just my suggestion. All right, so it has the transfer function of the form s plus z upon s plus p. So where is the zero of the function? Zero is s equal to minus z, and where is the pole of the function is s equal to minus p with the given condition p greater than z, but the magnitude of p greater than magnitude of z, the pole is away, the pole is away from the origin as compared to zero. So which of them is dominant? See, we have seen the dominant pole theory where we were comparing the pole versus pole. Okay, I am comparing a pole versus zero, but always which is the dominant one? Always the dominant one is the one that we have learned in the dominant pole class. The one which is closer to the imaginary axis is the dominant one. And here zero is closer to the origin. The zero is closer to the origin as compared to the pole, resulting in higher phase shifts. Resulting in higher phase shifts. Now how higher phase shifts, that all will be explained to you. The zero is closer to the origin as compared to the pole, resulting in higher phase shift. All right. Resulting in higher phase shift. Is that clear to everyone? Now, this is okay, this is just the definition, but let me tell you ki, yes, this is actually one very important type of question, repeated important one mark question. Suppose I give you GCS is equal to S plus 2 divided by S plus 4, whether it is a lead compensator or not. See, the zero is at s equal to minus 2 and the pole is at s equal to minus 4. Okay, zero is closer to the origin as compared to the pole, and that is known as a lead compensator. Okay, that is a lead compensator. See, I tell you the numericals from this part, as far as MCQ questions are concerned, as far as MCQ or NET questions are concerned, numericals are going to be much easy. And one of the common numerical, I've shown you this one only. I will show you the gate questions also, but this is one of the common ones. Okay, given a GCS, identify whether it is lead or lag. Okay, lag mein aapko kya bolunga? If the pole is closer to the origin, it's going to be a lag compensator. Okay, so if zero is closer to the origin, it is lead compensator. So this definition itself is very useful for you in a repeated type of question. This can be expected in the upcoming year also. Given the transfer function, identify lead versus lag. Okay, we'll see the gate questions also. Now, an example satisfying the lead compensator. What is the lead compensator? Okay, any compensator is lead compensator which has one pole and one zero, where the zero is closer to the origin. Zero is closer to the origin. Okay, all right. So let's take an example and let's work out with this example. If you look in this example, this R1 and C1, these two elements are in parallel. Let's say the effective impedance of this parallel combination is Z1. Okay, let's say this impedance is Z2, which is just equal to R2, the resistive part. And I am interested in calculating the transfer function of this system. Okay, so what will be the transfer function of this system can easily be discussed First, let us write down what is Z1. Z1 is R1 parallel with capacitance, and what is the impedance of the capacitor is 1 by SC1. So it is R1 into 1 by SC1 divided by R1 plus 1 by SC1. Okay, and that is equal to R1 is divided by 1 plus SR1 C1. R1 is divided by 1 plus SR1 C1. I'm multiplying by SC1. Correct? R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Yeah, Yashwant, I told now how resulting higher phase shift I am going to derive it. So just wait for it. I already told in the beginning ki, yes, we are going to see higher phase shift with the zero being closer to the origin or to the imaginary axis. Alright. Now, and what is the value of Z2? Z2 is just containing the R2, the resistant part. Okay. Now, what is the transfer function? So, what is the output voltage applying the voltage divider law? What is the voltage divider law of network? What is the voltage divider law of network? Z1, Z2, these are series impedance. Okay, so in the series, how the voltage is distributed? It is distributed in the respective fraction of the Z2 divided by the total impedance, total series impedance, Z2 upon Z1 plus Z2 into VIS. Okay, so what is my transfer function of this one? My transfer function TS is equal to, always defined as, ratio of output to the input voltage, output to the input Laplace transform, so that is Z2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. Let us put down the value of Z1, Z2. Let us put down the value of Z1, Z2. So what is the value of Z2 is just equal to R2 divided by Z1. So see guys, what is Z1? R1 divided by 1 plus SR1 C1 plus Z2, Z2 is equal to R2 multiplied by 1 plus SR1 C1. So R2 into 1 plus SR1 C1 whole divided by R1 plus R2 plus SR1 C1 R2 and just divide overall numerator denominator by R2. So you are going to get transfer function as dividing by R2 1 plus SR1 C1 divided by R1 plus R2 divide by R2 plus SR1 C1. This R2 is cancelled, this is cancelled, and here I have divided by R2. Fine. Now, here I'll just make a substitution. Here I'll just make a small substitution and get to the final transfer function. So, the substitution coming up where just let the RC, the time constant term, let R1 C1 equal to time constant T1 and let R2 divided by R1 plus R2 equal to alpha. Putting this values, what is the transfer function looking like? Okay guys, what is the transfer function looking like? 1 plus SR1 C1, that is 1 plus ST, let it be just T, only one time constant. Now 1 plus ST divided by R1 plus R2 divided by R2 will be reciprocal of alpha, that is 1 by alpha, plus the ST term again. Okay, so final transfer function, if you multiply by alpha, it is alpha 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S alpha T. 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S alpha T. All right. Now, does it satisfy the lead compensator condition, guys? Does it satisfy? Come on, quickly tell me. Does it satisfy the lead compensator condition? What is the condition? That pole and zero condition. Come on, guys, quickly comment. Does it satisfy the lead compensator condition or not? If yes, then it is an example of lead compensator. Okay. All right. Yes, it would satisfy actually. It would satisfy. It would satisfy. See, what is the zero? Zero is S is equal to minus 1 by T. And what is the pole? Is S is equal to minus 1 by alpha T. Okay, minus 1 by alpha T. Obviously, I have told you, what is C? What is alpha? Is R2 upon R1 plus R2. Here, one thing I should mention about alpha is that in the case of alpha, numerator is greater, smaller than the denominator. Denominator R1 plus R2, numerator is just equal to R2. Okay, so alpha is definitely less than 1. Always remember. Yeah, Saurabh, nothing to be about if alpha. It is always less than 1. Alpha is always less than 1. There is no if condition because the numerator is less than denominator, right? So because alpha is less than 1, 1 upon alpha will be greater than 1, and hence 1 upon alpha t, if I multiply by 1 by t both sides, 1 upon alpha t will be greater than 1 by t, the p greater than z. Z will come first. Okay. Z will come first. All right. So the sketch is basically 1 upon t with the minus sign, minus 1 by t coming first and then minus 1 by alpha t coming next. 0 is closer to the origin as compared to pole, and hence it's a lead compensator. So the given RC circuit is an example of lead compensator, is an example of lead compensator, right? Chaliye. If it is the lead compensator, now let us proceed with few more calculations. Let us proceed with few more calculations and look at those calculations. See, what is the transfer function? It is alpha. Okay. Now that fact, it results in higher phase shifts. So how that is true, we'll just look into that. 1 plus s alpha t. Okay. Achha, see, alpha less than 1 is just a constant. It's just a constant. Okay. It's just like a proportional constant. It's like proportional constant, you can say, something like Kp. Okay. When the gain is just constant, like the gain of the proportional controller. Okay. So, it will affect the steady state error. Okay. What I am going to do, let us only study the effect of pole and zero. How that higher phase shift is coming. Let us see the effect of pole and zero. Anyways, alpha is a constant. What is the phase due to alpha? What is the phase due to a positive real number? Is always zero. The phase due to a positive real number is always zero. Okay. It will affect the steady state error, but it can be nullified by multiplying constant, hai na, you can take one more constant gain having 1 by alpha, so alpha and 1 by alpha can be cancelled. There are ways to, you know, manage that alpha, but let us only study the effect of pole and zero. Let us only study the effect of pole and zero. Okay, so I'm just going to call the transfer function of the lead compensator T lead as 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus s alpha t. It could be taken with alpha also, but I just want to see the condition of pole and zero. Okay. No, Sindhu, actually they are being used to compensate for stability lot, but because a transfer function is being introduced, obviously certain other things will be affected. Okay, certain other things of the system will also be affected. Although their main role is to compensate, to talk about stability, but other parameters can also be dealt with this, can also be affected with this. How? That I'm going to tell you. Okay. And what are the general conclusions? Like yesterday, we were looking into the general conclusions of every controller. We will see here. Okay. So now let us do the analysis of this term, magnitude and phase analysis. Main is the phase analysis. So what is T lead J omega is 1 plus J omega T, converting into frequency domain first of all, divided by 1 plus j omega alpha t. Okay. 1 plus j omega alpha t. Now, what is the phase of this and what is the magnitude? Magnitude I'm taking just by the Bode approximation method. So, what are the corner frequencies? Corner frequencies. There is one corner frequency due to 0. That is 1 upon t. You know, 1 plus j omega t, 1 plus st, the corner frequency is 1 by t. There is one corner frequency due to pole, and that will be 1 upon alpha t. That will be equal to 1 upon alpha t, correct? Then, what is the initial part? What is the initial part of the Bode plot? Okay, the initial part of the Bode plot, guys, as you know the formula, this is important formula. I've used it in multiple questions, so I hope it must be set in your mind now. Minus 20 n log omega plus 20 log k. Okay. So put here n equal to 0. ठीक है, एनी नंबर ऑफ पोल्स एट ओरिजिन, तो देयर इज नो पोल एट ओरिजिन, एंड ऑल्सो पुट के इक्वल टू वन, द गेन के, द गेन के, तो व्हाट इज द गेन के, इट इज जस्ट लाइक वन इंटू वन प्लस एस टी, तो गेन के इज इक्वल टू वन, ओके, एंड दैट मीन्स द मैग्नीट्यूड इज 0 प्लस 20 log 1, log 1 is also 0, so it is 0 decibel. The magnitude is 0 dB. All right. With that, we will have the magnitude plot coming. I will show you the magnitude plot. I'll just show you the magnitude plot. Let me write down the phase formula also. Let me just write down the phase formula also. Okay. Now, what about the phase? Angle dj omega, the phase of the transfer function, the phase of the transfer function. Numerator by denominator, you know the phase for the denominator will be subtracted. So, what is the phase for the numerator? Tan inverse omega t. Then, denominator ke liye subtract tan inverse omega alpha t. Tan inverse y by x is applied for x plus y. Tan inverse omega t minus tan inverse omega alpha t. Omega alpha t. Correct? Now. If I take omega equal to 0, actual phase results I am taking. So, phase will be equal to tan inverse 0 minus tan inverse 0, that is 0. Okay. Let us take the first corner frequency omega equal to 1 by t. So, what is the phase equal to? At omega equal to 1 by t, you get tan inverse 1 by t and t cancel, tan inverse 1 minus tan inverse alpha. Okay. Now, let us take some numerical values. Let us take some numerical values. So just let alpha equal to 1 by 2. What is the only condition on alpha is that alpha should be less than 1. So you can take any value of alpha less than 1. So I've taken alpha equal to half. Okay. Let's put this in the calculator. Okay. You get phase is equal to tan inverse 1. That is 45 degree minus tan inverse 1 by 2. You are going to get the answer. You can check by your calculator. You are going to get the answer, which is approximately 18.43. Which is approximately 18.43. Okay. Now, let us put omega equal to 1 upon alpha t, the next corner frequency. The phase will be equal to tan inverse. See, omega equal to 1 by alpha t, the tan inverse of 1 by alpha minus tan inverse of 1. Tan inverse of 1 by alpha means tan inverse of 2 minus tan inverse 1, 45 degree. And guys, this is also going to come up as 18.43 degree. This will come up as same 18.43 degree. And if I put omega tending to infinity, finally, okay, the final value of phase will be omega tending to infinity, tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse infinity, 90 minus 90 will close at 0. Will close at 0. Okay, so I will show you the proper phase plot, but what is the variation of the phase approximately? Then I will tell you the final phase plot. Okay, what is the initial value of the phase? Is 0. What is the final value of the phase? 0. Matlab starting and ending is same. Also, what is the value of the phase at both the corner frequency? It is 18.43 and 18.43. That means the phase starts rising from 0. It reaches 18.4 degree. After some other frequency, it is again 18.4. It does not mean that it is constant here. Obviously, it's a function of omega. It's not a constant. So, this will not exist. So, what is this? What is the characteristic that we can draw out? It is increasing, and then after some frequency, it is again decreasing, so that you will get back the 18 degree. And decreasing, and finally tends to 0. Final phase is also 0. Okay, something like this. These are the proper shapes. And guys, this is alpha equal to half. But not only for alpha equal to half, you can take any value of alpha less than 1, like 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 5, anything you take. The phase has both the corner frequency. For any value of alpha, it is going to be same as I have given in this graph. The phase is common at both the corner frequency. That means the phase is starting from 0 degree. It rises. The phase is starting from 0 degree. It rises. It becomes 18 degree. Okay. After some more frequency, it is again 18 degree. That means it rises. And after rising, it reaches a peak value. It reaches a maximum. And then it starts falling. Again comes 18 and falling. It turns back to 0. Okay. That is the phase plot approximately. That is the phase plot approximately. My major interest here is, talking about this frequency, omega m, where you get the maximum phase, where you get the maximum phase of the function. Yeah, apart from that, the magnitude plot, see, what was the initial part of the Bode plot? This was the initial part calculation, then we started with phase. Initial part is 0 dB, so you can look at this one. Initial part is 0 dB, then comes the corner frequency, which will be first, 0. Theek, as I've shown you, 0 is first and then a pole. So, sabse pehle 0 comes, so slope changes by, you all know from the Bode, slope will change by plus 20 dB per decade and up to the next corner frequency. Next corner frequency is due to the pole, and due to the pole, slope will again change by minus 20. The plus 20 minus 20 is 0, and then hence you get a line parallel to the x-axis. There is no more pole and 0, matlab the line will continue till infinity. Line will be continued till the infinity. Okay. That is the approximate Bode magnitude plot. Okay, I'll just mention it here. This is what? This is the Bode magnitude plot, and this is the actual phase plot. See, at the end, phase is going to be important. You will understand it shortly. So, phase, I'm not taking any approximation. I've taken the direct phase plot. Okay, I've taken the direct phase plot. Alright, as you are also able to see, phase is always positive for any value of omega. Phase is always positive at any value of omega. Alright? Okay. Now, let us proceed forward. Let us proceed forward in calculating this point, that is phi m. What is the maximum phase and at what frequency that maximum phase occurs? At what frequency that maximum phase occurs? Let us start calculating that. So, what is the phase function? What is the phase function? It is tan inverse omega t minus tan inverse omega alpha t, and to obtain phi m, the maximum phase, what is the criteria that you can use? Is the basic calculus criteria, first derivative equal to 0, d phi by d omega equal to 0. Okay, so if I differentiate this, guys, if you differentiate this, I get 1 upon, what is the differentiation of tan inverse x? Is 1 upon 1 plus x square, and by the chain rule, is t minus 1 upon, it's just two line answer, 1 upon 1 plus omega square alpha square t square into alpha t, and that is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. Okay. Now, that means if I take t common, I am getting what? 1 plus omega square alpha square t square minus alpha omega square t square is divided by 1 plus omega square t square into 1 plus omega square alpha square t square. Anyways, we are interested only in numerator. Okay, because the for function to be 0, you can take the numerator as 0. So just take the numerator, that is 1 plus omega square alpha square t square minus alpha omega square t square equal to 0. Okay. So that means 1 minus alpha, and just if you combine these two terms, na, so you see some common elements. What is the common elements? Alpha omega square t square common, and then you get alpha minus 1 equal to 0. Or it can be written as 1 minus alpha. It can be written as 1 minus alpha. Take minus common, so minus alpha omega square t square, once again 1 minus alpha equal to 0. Now taking 1 minus alpha common, I get 1 minus alpha omega square t square equal to 0. Okay, so you get 1 minus alpha equal to 0. Okay, or 1 minus alpha omega square t square equal to 0. Okay, there are two solutions. Which of them should be taken? See, 1 minus alpha equal to 0 is not a possible solution because we know that alpha is always less than 1. So alpha cannot be equal to 1. alpha is less than 1, that we have concluded earlier only. Okay, so alpha cannot be equal to 1. So go for the second one, that is 1 minus alpha omega square t square. Okay, so alpha omega square t square is equal to 1. So what is the value of omega square? Is 1 upon alpha t square. All right, so what is omega? Now this is the omega at which you get the maxima. So I will call this frequency as omega m. I will call this frequency as omega m, that is 1 upon t root alpha. 1 upon t root alpha. Call this frequency as omega m, that is 1 upon t root alpha. Okay. After taking the square root. Now, at omega equal to omega m, the phase should be maximum, that is equal to phi m, and that is equal to tan inverse omega t, phase expression, minus tan inverse omega alpha t. Put the value of omega, it is tan inverse, omega is 1 by t root alpha into t, minus tan inverse, omega is again 1 by t root alpha and then into alpha t, right? Now t and t cancel, this is tan inverse 1 by root alpha minus tan inverse, tt cancel, alpha by root alpha is root alpha. Apply tan inverse a minus tan inverse b, guys. You are going to get 1 minus alpha divided by 2 root alpha. Tan inverse a minus b upon 1 plus ab. Upon 1 plus ab. You will get 1 inverse 1 minus alpha upon 2 root alpha. And that is also equal to, if I apply some trigonometry, that is also equal to sine inverse 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. Sin inverse 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. That can easily be proved by taking a triangle. Okay, by taking a triangle. Just I will give you the hint. That can be easily proved by taking a triangle. Trigonometry apply karenge. Tan theta, if you take this, tan theta is height by base. So height is 1 minus alpha and base is 2 root alpha. So what is the value of the hypotenuse that you can find? Okay, hypotenuse, how you can find the hypotenuse? By the Pythagoras theorem. Take under root of 1 minus alpha whole square plus 2 root alpha whole square. So by the Pythagoras theorem, you will be able to find out. Okay, and that hypotenuse will actually come up as 1 plus alpha. Sorry, denominator be 1 minus alpha nahi hoga. Obviously, it is 1 plus alpha. 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. So tan sin theta is what? Sin theta is height upon hypotenuse. You can find the hypotenuse by the Pythagoras theorem. You will get this answer. I've given you the hint. If you want, you can do it. Otherwise, I've given the final result. Sin inverse 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. Okay. Now, that means I will come back to this slide. I will come back to this slide to write down the results here also. So that you remember with this graph. Okay. The frequency at which the maximum phase occurring is, I will write down the answer here, 1 upon t root alpha, and the value of the maximum phase is given by sine inverse 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. Okay. Now, from here, from these two formula, with respect to questions I am telling guys, competitive question, MCQ or NET question, this set of formula forms the second important question. What is the first important question? I already told from compensator. Identify whether the compensator is lead or lag. Lead ka condition maine bola hai, lag ka will be reverse as you will see. Second important numerical question is based on this. Okay, given this lead compensator, what is the frequency at which the maximum phase lead occurs? And what is the value of that maximum phase? Okay, any one of the two or both of them can be asked. That is another numerical question. We will have a view of the numerical question. Let us complete all the derivations first. Okay. So these are the results. These are the results. Okay. Now. Just sketching something. Just hold on a minute. Let me sketch something and then I will discuss with you. Now, guys, please remember the Bode plot class. I hope you remember the Bode plot class. This is some Bode plot of GS. Okay, GS, not the compensator, any GS. Okay. This frequency at which the Bode plot, this frequency at which the Bode plot intersects the 0 dB axis is the gain crossover frequency. We have done questions on that also. And what do you calculate at the gain crossover frequency is the phase margin. So what do you calculate at the gain crossover frequency, guys, is the phase margin. Okay. On the x-axis, the phase is minus 180 degree. Okay. And the difference of 180 degree and that blue line, this blue line is the phase one, and that is the phase margin of the system. As you are able to see that the phase margin of the system is low, it's pretty low. Matlab system is at the verge of, you know, it has a risk of instability because phase margin is low. Okay. Suppose it is extremely low. If it is towards zero, then it is marginally stable. If it is negative, then it is unstable. The system is stable, but it is, it is stable by a very small margin. Okay. I want to improve the stability of system. I want to improve the stability of this system. See, actually, for MCQ question, for the gate level question, because this is the gate batch, not the ESE mains batch. With the gate level questions, I say whatever I have discussed till now, for questions, it is 100% sufficient. What is the phi m omega m and what is the pole zero condition of compensator? Okay. But still, I am explaining you the concept of stability. Otherwise, that concept will always be blank in the mind. Ki why we studied this compensator? With respect to questions, what is required? I have solved. That's it. Keval usi mein se majority questions aayega. I will show you the question. But to make you clear about the concept, otherwise you will always have in mind ki why that compensator, how it improved the stability, I am giving you a brief hint. Not solving in the conventional side, but still I am giving you a brief hint. You will understand with this hint. So understanding on the concept of compensator ki baat kar rahe. So suppose I want to improve the stability of this system. I want to improve the stability of this system. I now take the GCS, that is known as the lead compensator. GCS, I am using a lead compensator. Now guys, as seen, what is the magnitude plot for the phase? Okay, it has up to the 1 by T, up to the first corner frequency, it is 0 dB, and then it starts rising and then becomes constant. So let me just repeat that here. It is 0 up to a certain frequency. That is the corner frequency. Then it starts rising. And then it becomes constant when the next frequency comes, next corner frequency, that is 1 by alpha t. I will introduce the phase later on, but just listen. I want to improve the stability of the system. Obviously, that means improving the phase margin of the system. Okay, talking in terms of phase margin, guys. Now, where is this GCS placed? Let me take you back towards my first introduction. Yes. Guys, we are talking about the forward path compensator. We are talking about the forward path compensator where the GC is placed in cascade with GS. Okay. And whenever two blocks are in cascade, they are multiplied. Okay. So what is the effective gain now after multiplication will be equal to GCS into GS. Okay. But when you take the magnitude on the Bode, that is decibel, that is in the form of decibel. Okay. Bode plot me, you take the magnitude in decibel. So that is going to be 20 log mod of this, and mod of log of A into B is log A plus log B. 20 log mod GC J omega plus 20 log mod of GJ omega. Okay. Added. Exactly, Yugendra. That is what I wanted to listen. The magnitudes will be added because it is a log scale. Okay. Otherwise, it is multiplied, but in log, that is what was one of the advantage of using log. The multiplication get converted to easier terms of addition. And now those two Bode plots which I am talking, I will add them. Also, phi. Phi is not taken in log, but automatically whenever two complex numbers are multiplied, phi will be added. Angle of GC J omega plus angle of GJ omega. Angle of GJ omega. So angles will also be added. Okay, this is our basic discussion that we have been doing from the frequency response and Bode plot. So let us come back to this now. Okay, let us come back to this. This blue line which I have highlighted, I'll just write there. This is angle GJ omega, the phase, the original phase of this system. ओके नाउ गाइस लिसन वेरी केयरफुली, लिसन वेरी केयरफुली, अप टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी 1 बाय टी, जस्ट सी द रिलेशन, जस्ट सी द मैपिंग. अप टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी 1 बाय टी, ठीक है, देयर इज नो रोल ऑफ दिस फंक्शन. द लोअर फंक्शन इज 0 डीबी. What is this value? Zero. Okay. Let us say upper value is x. So guys, what is x plus zero? Is x. No change. That means up to this frequency, there is no change in the magnitude of the above one. Because what is the final magnitude? What is the final magnitude? Will be the mod of, will be 20 log mod, as I showed you there, gj omega plus the 20 log mod of compensator. Both are multiplied, so in the log they will be added. Okay, so up to this point there is no effect. Okay, but like, guys, listen very carefully, from the frequency 1 by t, the magnitude of the compensator in decibel is positive. This is positive, it is rising towards positive, it is positive, it is increasing and then it remains constant, but still it is positive. It is positive. So let's say the above magnitude is x and you add x plus positive, so obviously you are going to get a value which is greater than x. Which is greater than x. So what is going to happen actually? Let's see. What is going to happen now? Please look. From this point onwards, the magnitude value are going to be uplifted. Suppose this was the value, ye thoda upar chala jayega. This value goes above. This value goes above. This value goes above. So all the values are added. All the values are added with something. So the graph in a sense is uplifted. And because of upliftment, जो ओमेगा जी था द गेन क्रॉस ओवर फ्रीक्वेंसी दैट विल नो लॉन्गर बी अ गेन क्रॉस ओवर फ्रीक्वेंसी बिकॉज अर्लियर द मैग्नेट्यूड वॉज जीरो नाउ द जीरो प्लस समथिंग नाउ द जीरो प्लस समथिंग एंड बिफोर दैट I'll just introduce the phase line once again. Just wait for it. So now first understand the magnitude effect. Earlier, this was your omega g, but now okay, there would have been a magnitude which was negative and added negative plus positive. Now that magnitude is zero. Okay. One negative magnitude added with positive magnitude. So there will be some point afterwards which is going to be converted to zero magnitude. And then this is known as what? This will be actually your new gain crossover frequency. So one first time, first change, the gain crossover frequency shifted to a higher value. Everyone understood this? The gain crossover frequency shifted to a higher value. The gain crossover frequency shifted to a higher value. Okay. Now, wherever is the gain crossover frequency, there only I calculate the phase margin. So I will again sketch the phase plot of this. Now, guys, as you were able to see, this was your original phase margin. This was the old phase margin, which is very low. Okay. But now you will not see the phase margin at this point. You will see the phase margin at the new gain crossover frequency. Here it is extremely low, but don't worry, it is not extremely low. Why? Because when you are introducing the compensator, not only magnitude, it will also have the phase effect, na? And what are all the values of phase? It is positive. And as I told in the first discussion, as I told you here, look at this once again, because the transfer functions are in cascade, they are multiplied, that means the phase are added. So these phase of the original system, whether it is low, but when it is added with something, that low value will be raised above. Matlab, the phase will be shifted in the higher sense, higher phase shift. That is what actually is the meaning when I say, na, the zero is closer to the origin, resulting in higher phase shifts. Okay, the phase of the system will be shifted to higher values. Because originally the phase of the system, even if it is low, it is added with a positive quantity. Look at the whole graph. It is always in the positive value. All the values of the phase are positive. So some positive value is added. दैट मींस द ओवरऑल फेस विल बी रेस्ड. आपको केवल डिजाइन कैसे करना है, मैंने बोला आई एम नॉट टेकिंग अ कन्वेंशनल क्वेश्चन बट आई एम गिविंग यू द आइडिया अबाउट स्टेबिलिटी. ठीक है, तो वैल्यू बाय वैल्यू आई एम नॉट डिराइविंग इट बट गिविंग यू द आइडिया. ठीक है, फॉर एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन दिस इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट बट स्टिल फॉर योर कॉन्सेप्ट इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. तो वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू डिजाइन दिस पॉइंट, यू हैव टू डिजाइन दिस पॉइंट ओमेगा एम सच दैट इट कोलाइड्स विद द न्यू गेन क्रॉस ओवर फ्रीक्वेंसी. It collides with the new gain crossover frequency. So this new gain crossover frequency, okay, is omega m must be matched. It is the frequency with which omega m ko match karna hoga, and omega m is the frequency where the phase is maximum. Omega m is the frequency where the phase is maximum. I will just sketch the phase plot of the lead compensator here itself. And it has a maximum phase. It has a maximum phase at the frequency known as omega m. And this maximum phase phi m will be added with the original phase. And this graph also will be uplifted, improving, okay, increasing the phase margin. Increasing the phase margin. This is tentatively I have given. मैंने पूरा conventional style में solve नहीं किया. Have you understood the concept of stability? How the phase margins are uplifted by using the lead compensator? How the phase margin can be uplifted using the lead compensator? Yes, guys. Please, can you reply? How the phase margins are uplifted? Phase margin uplifted मतलब system has been, you know, system is more stable now. System is more stable. You can watch this section of the video once again. मैंने बोला numericals are going to be very easy. Numericals के लिए what is required I have told earlier. Numericals वाला part I have told earlier, but this is for your concept. Okay, you can refer to this 10-15 minute section once again. What I told you can refer it again for better clarity if you are any confusion. All right. Because if I take a proper design example, I can take, but almost 1 hour will go in that, and that is not for your at least gate or MCQ question. Okay. If I had additional time, I could have taken one design problem, but that will take at least 1 hour to solve the system completely with the proper values. But yeah, idea is the same. For you, concept, zaruri tha, maine concept bata diya, general effects of the phase lead compensator. General effects of the phase lead compensator. It adds both a pole and zero with the effect of zero being more dominant. This is what I have told from the beginning only. Effect of zero being more dominant because it is closer to the origin. Then it shifts omega g to a higher value. As seen here. Okay. This was the old omega g and this is your new omega g. Matlab gain crossover frequency shifted to the higher value. Due to which the bandwidth of the system has increased, matlab the gain of a system. Theek. Aap fir se isko samajh sakte hain is tarike se. Let me take the pen, just a second. Okay, omega g is the frequency at which the magnitude is 0 dB. Magnitude matlab which magnitude? Log magnitude. 20 log mod gj omega is 0. That means mod gj omega equal to 1 in absolute form. And that was the actual definition of omega g. The frequency at which the Nyquist plot cuts the unit circle. Magnitude equal to 1. Okay. So, before omega g, what is mod of gj omega? It is greater than 1. Na? Before this omega g, the magnitude is greater than 1. Okay. That is why it is positive. It becomes 1 and then it decreases further. So before omega g, the magnitude is greater than 1. And if the gain of the system is greater than 1, that means it is amplifying the input signal. If the gain of a system is less than 1, then the output gain will be less than the input gain. That is known as attenuator. But if a system produces output gain greater than the input gain, that is only known as amplification. Okay. So it will be able to amplify a larger range of frequency because omega g, which is old and new, if you compare, it has shifted to a larger value. That means there will be more amount of frequency which will be amplified by the system. And that is why I put the conclusion here that the bandwidth of the system increases. Okay, The rise time and settling time. Bandwidth and rise time are inversely proportional to each other. We have learned in the frequency class, frequency response class. The bandwidth increase, matlab rise time decrease. Okay. settling time will also decrease with that. The phase of the transfer function, the two important points I will highlight, two important effects of the lead compensator, omega g is increased, and the phase of the transfer function near the gain crossover frequency increases. How it increases, I've showed you, which increases the phase margin of the system, hence making the system more stable. The phase of the transfer function near the gain crossover frequency, near the new gain crossover frequency, the phase of the original transfer function, this was the old phase, now it will be added with this new phase. The old plus new will be a higher, better phase, will be a uplifted phase. Will be uplifted phase, and thereby improving the phase margin of the system. The steady state performance is not affected. Okay, because I neglected that factor alpha, and I told alpha can be multiplied by n by alpha, that is equal to 1. Okay, if there is some alpha, that will affect the steady state. Okay, guys, the time for screenshots. Let us similarly also see the lag compensator. And then we will go towards the lead lag and then numericals. Numericals I will take all together. So starting from the lead compensator. Yes. Screenshot, guys. Yes, Zion. Omega G is increased after 1 by T. Yes, 1 by T is helpful for increasing omega G, and omega M will help for increasing the phase margin by keeping at new omega G. Exactly, that is how it is designed. The omega M is the property of compensator, and that value is desired to be at the new gain crossover frequency. First, the new gain crossover frequency is calculated by the increased magnitude of the system. Okay, increased magnitude depends on 1 by T. Screenshot, guys. Next one. Next. Next. Next one. Next. Next screenshot. Next one. Next. Next one. नेक्स्ट वन, यस पवन, दिस रेड लॉट रेड डॉटेड लाइन इज नथिंग बट द इंक्रीज वैल्यू ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड आफ्टर दिस पॉइंट, बिकॉज आफ्टर दिस पॉइंट दिस ओल्ड मैग्नीट्यूड विल बी एडेड विद दिस न्यू मैग्नीट्यूड कब कमिंग, ओके दैट इज वाई इट इज इंक्रीज अपलिफ्टेड, ओके पवन, फाइनल स्क्रीनशॉट रिगार्डिंग द जनरल इफेक्ट्स. Okay guys, now come on quickly. All the derivations will be very similar, so I don't think derivations will again be repeated here, will be very similar. A phase lag compensator has the transfer function of the form S plus Z upon S plus P with Z greater than P. In this case, the pole is closer to the origin. It's vice versa. In this case, the pole is closer to the origin as compared to zero. Okay, the effect of pole is more dominant. The effect of pole is more dominant, resulting in lower phase shifts. Earlier it was higher phase shift. S plus Z, 0 is at minus Z, pole is at minus P, Z greater than P, matlab Z will come next, P is less than Z, so P wala term will come first. Okay, so for example, and again I told you this is one important question, this is one important type of question. So suppose I give you a compensator GCS equal to S plus 3 divided by S plus 1. So whether it is lead or lag, whether it is lead or lag, so where is my 0? Minus 3. And where is my pole? Minus 1. Pole is closer. Pole minus 1. Chota magnitude hai. So that is why pole is closer to the origin. So it is an example of lag compensator. Okay. It is an example of lag compensator. Theek hai. But trust me, this is an very simple but a very expected and repeated question. Identify lead versus lag. So remember, just the pole zero condition. Zero dominant, lead compensator. Pole dominant, lag compensator. Okay. Now an example, as we have seen for the lead one, an example here. Okay. This is suppose an impedance Z1, which is purely resistive R1. And towards the output side, I have taken R2 and C2 in series with each other. And that is the impedance Z2. That is the impedance Z2. R2 and C2 has been taken in series. Again, applying the voltage divider law. Again, applying the voltage divider law. See, what is Z2? Z2 is series R2 and C2. Matlab R2 plus 1 by SC2. Okay. And what is the value of Z1? It is just equal to R1. It's just equal to R1. So, very quickly, you will be able to come to the transfer function. Again, by the voltage divider, V0 divided by VI, known as the transfer function of the system, and that will be the ratio of the impedance Z2 across the output divided by the total series impedance Z1 plus Z2. Okay, just placing the values and some rearrangement, Z2 is R2 plus 1 by SC2 divided by Z1, which is R1 plus R2 plus 1 by SC2, multiply by SC2, so you get 1 plus S R2 C2 is divided by 1 plus S C2, 1 plus S R1 plus R2 into C2. Okay. That is what I am getting right now. Okay. Only one small modification has to be done. So let this transfer function, and then it is almost in the final form. It is 1 plus S R2 C2 divided by 1 plus 1 plus S R1 plus R2 into C2 है ना, तो see R1 plus R2 into C2, so I multiply R2 and I also divide R2 here within this term, okay, and now put the substitutions, and now put the substitutions, let R2 C2 be the time constant term T, and R1 plus R2 divided by R2, let this be equal to beta. So what will be the comment on beta, guys? This time the numerator is greater than denominator. R1 plus R2 is greater than R2. So beta will be greater than 1. Remember, beta will be greater than 1. Okay, beta will be greater than 1, and if beta is put finally, so what is the transfer function that you are going to get? You get 1 plus s r2 c2, matlab 1 plus st upon 1 plus s beta t, 1 plus st upon 1 plus s beta t. Yeah, Saurabh, you can remember like that also. Suppose you name it as alpha only. Suppose 1 plus st upon 1 plus s alpha t, alpha greater than 1. In the lead, it was alpha less than 1. So that way also you can remember. Okay, finally, it turns out to be the same condition of colon 0. So where is the 0 of the transfer function? Whether it is lag or not, first of all, let us see. Where is the 0? S is equal to minus 1 by t. And where is the pole? S is equal to minus 1 upon beta t. Okay, but we know that the beta is greater than 1, so obviously 1 upon beta is less than 1, so 1 upon beta t term is less than 1 upon t term. 1 upon beta t less than 1 by t clearly says that what is going to come first is the pole. The magnitude of pole is less than the magnitude of the 0. First the pole and then the 0. The pole is closer to the origin, confirming that yes, it is a lag compensator. So this given circuit, this given electrical network is clearly an example of lag compensator. Okay, what is the final transfer function I will put? T lag, what is the final transfer function? It is 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S beta T with beta greater than 1. Okay, that is the transfer function of the lag. Alright, now when I take the magnitude here, when I take the magnitude and phase consideration, put S equal to j omega, you get tj omega as 1 plus j omega t divided by 1 plus j omega beta t divided by 1 plus j omega beta t. Okay. And what are the corner frequencies? What are the corner frequencies? There is a corner frequency due to 0, that is 1 by t. And there is a corner frequency due to pole, that is 1 upon beta t. But as I have already confirmed for you, pole will come first. So what about the magnitude response of this system? Let me just guess the magnitude part first. The Bode magnitude plot. Okay. Like the last case, starting with 0 dB, but first you get 1 upon beta t, first the pole, and pole will introduce a negative slope, and due to negative slope, it falls. Okay. Then comes the corner frequency of the 0, which will make the slope 0. Here the slope is minus 20. And then minus 20 plus 20, it's going to make it as 0. Now, this is the magnitude part. And then what about the phase part? I'm doing similarly, not repeating everything like initial part and all. What about the phase result? Phase is... numerator by denominator, you can subtract the tan inverse omega t minus tan inverse omega beta t. But we know that beta is greater than 1. That means one of the phase term involves omega t, the other one involves omega beta t. One is omega t, another one is omega beta t, beta greater than 1. The one having beta will be larger in value. The second term is greater than the first term. The phase is always going to be negative. The function is very similar. The function is very similar like the last case. Tan inverse omega t minus tan inverse omega alpha t. Okay, tan inverse omega alpha t, the functionally it is same, but it is going to be negative in value. It is going to be negative in value. And what is the phase plot seen? What is the phase plot seen? I will sketch that also quickly. It is just negated in values as compared to the earlier one. As compared to the earlier one, and the plot is of this kind. And the plot is of this kind. Again, there comes an important frequency omega m where the phase is minimum, or you can say that the magnitude of the phase is maximum. This is phi m. Same formula, okay, same derivation. Why it is the same derivation? How did you derive phi m, guys? By d phi by d omega equal to 0. Now, d phi by d omega is same. Na keval, there is the change of one constant. Alpha is replaced by beta. But with respect to omega, it is the same function. Okay. So, you have same derivation because of the same function. And you get the results. You get obviously the same results. So, need not write that derivation again. What are the results? I will just write down the results. Omega m equal to, guys, omega m is equal to, recall the formula, it was 1 upon t root alpha derived. Just constant ko change kar dije, let replace alpha by beta. This is also easy for you. Now you have to remember only one set of formula, only replace alpha by omega. Phi m, what was the phi formula for phi m? It was written as sine inverse 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. Just replace the alpha by beta. Sine inverse 1 minus beta divided by 1 plus beta. So you have the similar set of formula because you will have the same derivation like the last case. Need not repeat the derivation. These are the final formula. All right. Okay, guys, so take on the screenshots for this one. Take the screenshots up to this point first, the lag compensator. Next one. Next screenshot. Next screenshot. Next one. Next. Next one. Next. Okay. Also take the screenshot for the effects. It adds both a pole and zero with the effect of pole being more dominant, already discussed. And other results are almost reciprocal, the inverse of the earlier one. Omega G lower ho jayega, that is why bandwidth decreases and hence the rise time increases. Okay, this time the gain near the transfer function will be attenuated, which improves the relative stability by shifting omega g to a lower point. And if omega g less than omega p, then the system is stable. Okay. Steady state performance is not affected. Okay, so I'm not repeating it as most of the concepts are similar, but just opposite of the lead compensator. You can just take down your notes. So already you have learned a lot about the polar plot. So guys, one homework for you regarding the polar plot. polar plot of the lead and lag compensator for both the transfer function. Just catch the polar plot. You have done similar activity earlier. Shape will almost be similar, only quadrant will change for lead and lag. So take the screenshot for your homework. Polar plot for lead and lag compensator. Next. Phase lead lag compensator. It is basically constructed as a cascade connection of lead and lag network. As you can see, the network up to this part is the lead network. Okay, this is your lead network, the first one. And the second network is the lag network, and both of them are connected in cascade. The output of the lead is connected as the input of the lag compensator, and this is your final output V0. This is your applied input VI. Okay. Now, because they are connected in cascade with each other, so do we need to find the transfer function? No, we don't need to derive the transfer function. Transfer function, when two systems are in cascade, the transfer functions are just multiplied. So the overall transfer function will be equal to product of the transfer function of lead into the transfer function of lag. Okay, so that is what here it is. Just let us write it directly. V0 by VI is the transfer function of lead into transfer function of lag. What was the transfer function of lead? Alpha 1 plus S T1 upon 1 plus S alpha T1 into 1 plus S T2 upon 1 plus S beta T2. So now, here let us write down first of all by our knowledge, for the first network, that is the lead one, this one is lead, the other one is lag. Let's not disturb this. I'll just take a new fresh page for this. Let us not disturb this. It will be helpful for your notes. Just a second. Okay. Now, let us take this, and as I'm telling, the network up to here is your lead network, and this is your lag network. And according to lead network, what were the substitutions? The transfer function for the lead was 1 plus ST upon 1 plus S alpha T whole multiplied by alpha. Let this T be equal to T1. Another T will be coming. So what is T1? What is T1? Was the product of R1 C1. And what was alpha? Alpha less than 1. It was the ratio R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, this was about lead. Okay, then what was the transfer function of lag? That is just we have derived. That is 1 plus ST upon 1 plus S beta T, let the T be equal to T2. So what was T2? Product of R4 C4, not R2 C2, just variables will be named, change R4 C1. And what was beta? It was R1 plus R2, means R3 plus R4 actually divided by R2, jahan pe R4 aa jayega. Okay, R1 plus R2 divided by R2, so it is R3 plus R4 divided by R4. Okay, that is what I've just written here, that is what. Transfer function both multiplied, where T1 is equal to R1 C1, the T2 is equal to R4 C4, alpha is R2 upon R1 plus R2, and beta is R3 plus R4 divided by R4. That is what we just written in. All derivation just copied, multiplied, because it is the cascade connection. Okay. Now, what about the pole zero? What about the pole zero diagram? For pole zero, we'll have to assume a relation between T1 and T2, which of them is less than the other one. If T1 is less than T2, then what happens? And if T1 is greater than T2, then what happens? What is the pole zero condition? To see, if I just write down the value of pole zero, zero is minus 1 by T1 and minus 1 by T2. There are two zeros I have written here. Minus 1 by T1, minus 1 by T2. Then take out the poles. Minus 1 by alpha T1, minus 1 by beta T2. Yahan se poles aa jayega. Minus 1 by alpha T1, minus 1 by beta T2. These are the poles. Okay. But what we know for alpha, I'll do the rough calculation. Alpha is less than 1, so 1 by alpha will be greater than 1. Okay. So, sabse pehle I've assumed T1 is less than T2. So, obviously, 1 upon T1 is greater than 1 upon T2. So, pehle 1 upon T2 aayega. Look at this. And then 1 upon T1 aayega. And then with respect to T1, 1 upon T1, 1 upon alpha T1 will be more away, because 1 upon alpha is greater than 1 upon alpha is greater than 1. Similarly, beta is greater than 1, so 1 upon beta will be less than 1. 1 upon beta, matlab 1 upon beta T2 will be less than 1 upon T2. So 1 upon T2 se less than hoga 1 upon beta T2, so 1 upon beta T2 will come first. So what is the pole zero arrangement? It starts with a pole, okay? दोनों तरफ पोल्स है, ठीक है, एंड देन यू हैव टू जीरोस इन बिटवीन. अंडरस्टूड दिस? दिस इज अंडर द असम्पशन दैट T1 इज लेस देन T2. ओके, सो दिस कॉन्फिगरेशन यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर इट लाइक दिस. दीज आर रफ थिंग्स, आई विल इरेज देम. दिस वॉज जस्ट फॉर योर एक्सप्लेनेशन. This configuration, there are two configuration for pole zero of lead lag compensator. इस पे भी MCQ questions हैं gate में, तो just remember this is P Z Z P configuration, ठीक है? दो poles के बीच में दो zeros हैं, P Z Z P configuration, ठीक है? If I assume the reverse, if T1 is greater than T2, तो what is the thing? What is the picture that you will see? I will sketch that picture. If T1 is greater than T2, if T1 is greater than T2, then you will have a reverse picture. You will have a reverse picture. See, 1 upon T1 is less than 1 upon T2. Okay. Zeros ki baat kar rahe hai, toh what is that first zero? What is that first zero will be 1 upon T1. Minus 1 by T1. With respect to minus 1 by T1, I sketch the pole minus 1 by alpha T1. And then comes the 0, minus 1 by T2. And with respect to minus 1 by T2, minus 1 by beta T2 will be on the right. Okay, so here you will be getting the configuration that is Z, P, P, Z. So it is either P, Z, Z, P or Z, P, P, Z. Matlab either two zeros in between or two poles in between. Okay, something like that. Also, quick things to remember. Also, if first case was T1 less than T2, huh? Yeah, first case I took T1 less than T2. Okay. Maybe, but even if they ask Zeeshan, they will be conceptually able to solve. Can possible, they can ask, not a big deal. Not really expected, but it's not like impossible also. Okay, so if T1 is less than T2, T1 less than T2, to see guys, what comes first is a pole. What is the most dominant term? Pole. Okay, what is the most dominant term? Pole. So just look at these plots. Most dominant term will be the pole. And because the pole is dominant, so first of all, when you start the magnitude plot, sabse pehle you get the pole. Pole will change the slope by negative. Then comes, after the pole, it is what? I'm just reading in reverse. First pole, then zero, then zero, then pole. So zero, okay, will again change the slope to zero. It will increase it to zero. It will further increase the slope to positive. Then comes a pole, which will make the slope zero. So this will be approximately your magnitude plot. Phase plot, again first pole is there, and because the pole is dominant, lower phase shift, matlab negative, okay. Then comes a zero which is going to pull the phase values to higher end, again a zero which will make the phase more positive, and then comes a pole which will pull back the phase and make it convert to zero. Similarly, if T1 is greater than T2, that is the other one. So what is more dominant is Z. If T1 is greater than T2, what is more dominant is Z. What is more dominant is Z. So how will be the magnitude and plot? I'm giving you the correct plot only, but just by logic, without any derivation. Just by our basic concept, who comes first, which is more dominant, I'm giving you the nature of the plot, which is derived after a big lot of derivation, which is not important for you anyways, that big complicated derivation for lead lag. But just by the knowledge of pole and zero and their dominance, this time guys, the zero is dominant if T1 is greater than T2. The first zero will come, the first the slope will positive, the line will increase. Then comes a pole here, the slope is again back to zero. plus 20 minus 20 0. Again a pole, ZPPZ, again a pole, the slope negative. And then after some time comes a 0, which will make slope equal to 0. Okay, the slope will be 0. Because the 0 is dominant, so firstly the face will be higher. Okay. Then comes a pole which will bring the face to the lower values, which will pull back the face. It reaches a maxima, it comes back to 0. Again a pole, the face, it will bring the face more lower, matlab negative side. And again comes a 0. Now 0 will pull the face again to some positive side. And finally the face will complete at 0. Close at 0. These are approximately, but yet perfect. Approximately but yet perfect magnitude and phase diagrams of the lead lag compensator just by logically the knowledge of pole and zero without doing the detailed calculation. Aur aapko MCQ mein aisa hi approach rakhna hai. There have been simple one or two marker question just by the concept of pole zero, not by calculation. See, gate one or two mark question cannot demand a derivation of lead lag, it is very big. But logic pe aap jaoge to sara question solve ho jayega. चलिए, नाउ व्हाट आर दोज वैरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन, लीड पे, लैग पे, लीड लैग पे. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दोज वैरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू कैन टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट फॉर लीड लैग, यू कैन टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट फॉर लीड लैग गाइस. कैस्केड कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ लीड एंड लैग, टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट्स क्विकली. द नेक्स्ट वन, just I've shown the calculation once again, what we derive, the transfer function of lead and the transfer function of lag, and then it is multiplied to get back the complete transfer function of lead lag, where alpha, beta, t1, t2 I've just written. Then important things, their pole zero diagram and the magnitude and phase results. First t1 less than t2, first t1 less than t2. So T1 less than T2 is PZZB configuration. Only two configuration will be there, PZZP or ZPPP. The next one is ZPPP if T1 is greater than T2. Okay. If T1 less than T2, pole is more dominant. So sabse pehle lower phase shift and lower magnitude. Next one, T1 greater than T2, 0 is dominant, the first higher phase shifts and higher magnitude, increasing magnitude due to the dominance of the 0. What is the dominance of 0 in pole that we individually saw with the lead and lag compensator? Now, simple question it is, can you answer this? Gate 2012 2 mark link questions, 2 plus 2, 4 marks. The above one is also 2 marks. It's also 2 marks. Just maybe not written here. 2 plus 2, 4 mark link question. Anyways, there is no link question pattern in gate now, but it used to be. And see how simple question they have, you know, asked only for 4 marks. That is what I want to focus. Compensator, jaise topic se aapko, you know, you don't have to be fair about, because question will actually be much simpler than what the topic is. अब एक सिंपल सी बात करता हूं आपके पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से. क्वेश्चंस आर मच सिंपलर देन व्हाट द टॉपिक इज. क्वेश्चन बहुत सिंपल रहेंगे ऐसे. द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन ऑफ अ कंपनसेटर इज गिवन टू यू, एस प्लस ए अपॉन एस प्लस बी. जीसीएस इज अ लीड कंपनसेटर इफ, द लीड कंपनसेटर इफ, ऑब्वियसली पोल्स एंड जीरोस मस्ट बी इन एलएचपी, डोंट टेक इट इन द आरएचपी. ओके, डोंट टेक इट इन द आरएचपी. यस गाइस, सो ऑलमोस्ट फर्स्ट का तो सब लोग आंसर देना प्लेस कर रहे हैं. फॉर लीड कंपनसेटर, फॉर लीड कंपनसेटर, जीरो शुड बी क्लोजर टू द ओरिजिन एज कंपेयर टू द पोल, पोल शुड बी अवे, पोल शुड बी अवे. नाउ व्हाट इज द कंडीशन, व्हाट इज द पोल हेयर, एस इक्वल टू माइनस बी, एंड व्हाट इज द जीरो हेयर इज एस इक्वल टू माइनस ए. So from this I should conclude that B should be greater than A. B should be greater than A leads to option number A. Option number A, B should be greater than A. ठीक है, इसको तो आप cancel कर दें, because if you take minus 3 and minus 1, poles and zeros will be in LHP. ठीक है, I will just mention it here. Both must be in LHP. Okay, so option number A, for the question number first, option number A is done. For the question number first, option number A is done. Now, second one is based on the formula. Can you quickly give me the answer for second one also? Rahul, second wala ek baar recheck kariye. The phase of the above lead compensator is maximum at what frequency? Matlab they are just asking the omega m. So see, it is pretty simple. It is pretty simple. Okay. So now from the question number one, it is clear that what is A and B? A is 1 and B is equal to 2. A is 1 and B equal to 2. Okay. If A is 1 and B equal to 2, what is the transfer function of the compensator? GCS is equal to S plus 1 divided by S plus 2. Okay. What I can write here is, it is 1 plus S divided by 2 common 1 plus S by 2. Standard form. And this is equal to 1 by 2. 1 plus S divided by 1 plus S by 2. Compare it by alpha 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S alpha T. You get the value of alpha and T, and you get your answers as well. What is the value of T is 1. And what is the value of alpha is half. So what is omega M? The frequency at which, only the frequency pucha hai. The phase of the above lead compensator is maximum at dash radian per second. Radian per second matlab frequency. So 1 upon T root alpha. So 1 upon 1 into under root of alpha. Alpha is half. So 1 upon 1 by root 2 will become root 2. Option number A. Very simple question for 4 mark. Option number A. Right. See the next question. Once again, very simple for 2 mark. Once again, very simple for 2 mark. Yeah, Yogendra, it is the geometric multiplicity. Yes, it is the geometric mean. You can say that. Zion and Yogendra, you can say that. It is the GM of the corner frequencies. Correct. Because the corner frequencies are 1 by T and 1 by T root alpha. Okay. Sorry. 1 by T and 1 by alpha T. The multiplication of them is 1 by T square alpha, and under root of them will be 1 by T root alpha. It is GM of the corner frequencies. Okay. Yes, correct. So see, this is again simple. Na, C nahi hoga, guys. Please check again. It is A. Everyone, you're giving the answer as A. So what is C1? So C1 mein aap dekhenge, the pole is minus 10, the zero is minus 1. Okay, so this is closer. This is closer to origin. What is closer to origin? Zero is closer to origin. So this is lead. This is lead. What about C2? C2 mein the pole is at minus 1, 0 is at minus 10. So pole value, the magnitude is small. The pole is closer to origin. And whenever the pole is closer to origin, that is a lag compensator. C1 is lead and C2 is lag. Just that's it. Very simple. Okay. Very simple. Next one. Gate 17, 1 mark question. Which of the following can be the pole zero configuration of a lag controller or a lag compensator? Lag. Okay, let us just write down. Pole is closer to the origin. Pole dominant, that is lag. Zero dominant, this one is lead. Okay. This is ZPPZ. And this is P, sorry. First one is PZZP and this is ZPPZ. Okay, so these are what? Lead lag compensators. Lead lag compensators. Okay, the correct option is option number A. Acha, although lead lag ek hi configuration hota hai, but just I will tell you, I'll go back to the previous slides, previous images. Okay, yahan pe sabse pehle. Both of these cases are lead lag only, but still we can distinguish this when T1 less than T2. Listen, guys, First, the effect of pole is dominant. मतलब first the lag one is coming. So we can call this as lag lead. We can call it as lag lead.
Okay.
And here, what T1 greater than T2, the effect of zero is dominant. मतलब first the lead type of characteristics is coming and then the lag type of characteristics is coming. Okay. So we can call this as lead lag. Lead lag. Although generally both can be called as lead lag only. Okay. Lag lead or lead lag से भी distinguish किया जाता है. That means if I come to this diagram, pole is dominant, matlab it will be lag lead. And here the zero is dominant, so it will be lead lag. Although, I repeat again, although both can also be said as lead lag generally, but they are also subclassified as lag lead or lead lag. Based on ki kiska effect pehle aa raha hai. Okay. As far as option is correct, A is the simple option that you have to mark. Very simple question again. Lag compensator, pole should be closer to the origin. Okay. So it is just previous question was with values. This is just with diagram, observation, just pure observation of your eyes. Where is pole closer to the origin? That is my lag controller. Got it? Chaliye. Kindly take the screenshot of first these 2-3 questions. These are simple ones. Take the screenshots quickly. Screenshot of these questions quickly. Next one. Next. Next question. Now a next question, guys. Next question on screen. A lead compensator network includes a parallel combination of RC in the feed forward path. If the transfer function of the compensator is S plus 2 upon S plus 4, what is the value of RC? What is the value of RC? Again, very simple. Again, this is very simple. GCS S plus 2 divided by S plus 4. Standard form twice 1 plus S by 2. Divided by, see, very simple for 2 marks, 4 times 1 plus S by 4. Cancel the 4 and 2. Yes, Girish and Anjana. So it is equal to 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. 1 plus S by 2 divided by 1 plus S by 4. This is of the form alpha 1 plus ST divided by 1 plus S alpha T. Comparing T, which is the product of RC, comparing both, the T is equal to 1 by 2. Answer is 0.5. That's it. See, very simple. Just a one-liner question for 2 marks. Maine bola, the questions of this category are very simple questions from compensator. In any MCQ exam, the question of compensators are like very scoring. Are like scoring, you can say. Theek hai? Isi ke saath screenshot bhi le lijiye. Take the screenshot also in parallel. Answer is 0.5. Next question now. For the network shown in the figure, the frequency in radian per second at which the maximum phase lag occurs. The frequency at which the maximum phase lag occurs for the network shown below. The frequency at which the maximum phase lag occurs. So, yahan pe nothing you have to do. See, what is the value of the time constant is RC. R matlab R2C2. That is 1 into 1. 1 ohm and 1 farad. So, T is equal to 1. What is the value of beta? You just have to remember the standard formula. R1 plus R2 divided by R2. So R1 plus R2, that is 9 plus 1 divided by 1. So this is equal to 10. So what is the frequency at which the maximum phase lag occurs is 1 by T root beta. 1 by T root beta. So that is equal to 1 by 10. 1 by T. T is 1 into root beta. 1 upon root 10. 1 upon root 10. Yes, exactly. This is going to come up as 0.316. Make it as root 10 by 10. Root 10 is 3.16. So 0.316 radian per second. Yes. 0.316 radian per second. दिस इज ऑल्सो डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला क्वेश्चन, करेक्ट। स्क्रीनशॉट ले लीजिए, पैरेलली स्क्रीनशॉट, देन वी गो टूवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन देन गाइस, द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन ऑफ अ कंपनसेटर इज गिवन टू यू, व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम फेज लीड ऑफ द कंपनसेटर एंड एट व्हाट फ्रीक्वेंसी, एंड एट व्हाट फ्रीक्वेंसी। It was asked way back in GATE 2000 for 2 marks and repeated the same question in ESC 2016. The transfer function of a compensator is given to you. 0.5 s plus 1 upon 0.05 s plus 1. What is the maximum phase lead of the compensator? And at what frequency? Yes, Sarthak. So what is t here guys? 0.5. And what is alpha t? 0.05. Okay, that means alpha into 0.5 is 0.05. So the value of alpha will be 0.1 actually. Alpha is 0.1, t is 0.5. Okay, so now the formulas. The formulas. Omega m is 1 by t root alpha. 1 by t, t kitna bola maine, t is 0.5, root alpha, alpha is 0.1. Let's see how much is this calculation coming up. Yes, this is coming up as 6.32 radian per second. 6.32 radian per second. With this only it should be clear ki none of the option is correct. None of the option has 6.32. Okay, so I always say if one calculation is able to solve the question, go mark the option, go for the next question, option number D. Okay. Apart from that, if you are still interested in 5m, so that I will just calculate for better clarity. Sine inverse 1 minus alpha upon 1 plus alpha, that is alpha is 0.1, so sine inverse of 0.9 divided by 1.1, and that is equal to 54.9 degree. Okay, that is approximately 55. Okay, that is approximately 55. Okay. But still the frequency does not match. The option is D. Option is D. All right, screenshot for this question. See, simple questions for 2 mark. I will hide my view. Screenshot for this question. Next screenshot. Now, look at this next question. It was asked in GATE 2006, 2 marks, repeated in ESC 15, repeated in the same form in ESC 2018 as well. So, a common question. The transfer function of a phase lead compensator is given to you as 1 plus 3TS upon 1 plus TS. With t greater than 0, the maximum phase shift provided by such a compensator is how much? Maximum phase shift, 5m. Yes, Payal, that's the previous slide. Options are there. What is the maximum phase shift provided by this? Yes, Shubham and Sarthak, correct answer. Yes, Anjana, correct answer. Yashwan, Deepa, Sachitra, correct answers. Very good. Shivashankar, correct answer. Likita, Giri, Zion, all correct answers. Preetam, Masum, Sindhu, Abhiram, Ram Prasad, Shreya, आई जस्ट हैव टू रीड द नेम्स, बाकी रेस्ट आंसर्स आर और कॉमन गिवन बाय यू. यस साक्षी, दैट्स वेरी गुड. कंसिस्टेंसी इज मेंटेन्ड बाय द क्लास, ऑल कमिंग अप विद द कॉमन आंसर. यस शालिनी, पायल, वेंकटेश, आनंद, भगवती, सौरभ, संदीप. चलिए नाउ लेट्स मी सॉल्व. इट इज जस्ट और कॉमन आंसर्स गिवन बाय ऑल. यस अथर्वा एंड देबशीष आल्सो. संदीप, मैक्सिमम फेज शिफ्ट, एंड फॉर मैक्सिमम फेज शिफ्ट दैट 5m वी ओनली नीड द वैल्यू ऑफ अल्फा. We only need the value of alpha. So what is GCS given to me is 1 plus 3TS divided by 1 plus TS. See, we commonly write numerator as 1 plus ST. Okay, so you can write it as 1 plus ST still. There is no problem. Okay, what you can do, you can just let 3T equal to T dash. If you want the standard form, if you want the standard form, if you want the standard form, you can let 3t equal to t dash, so that your GCS, okay, is 1 plus st dash divided by 1 plus st, and t will be equal to t dash divided by 3. So from there, if it is 1 plus st upon 1 plus s alpha t, comparison pe alpha a gaya 1 by 3. So what is phi m? Is just sine inverse 1 minus alpha upon 1 plus alpha, straight formula. So it is sine inverse 1 minus alpha is 2 by 3, 1 plus alpha will be 4 by 3. So 2 and 4 cancel, sine inverse half is 30 degree, that is pi by 6, pi by 6, option number D. That's it. That's it, solved. Take the screenshot. Number one, and this is the number two. Screenshot number two. Okay. Now, next question. Gate 17, 1 mark question. The transfer function of a compensator is given below. Two poles and two zeros. So, definitely, this is neither lead nor lag. The frequency in which the phase lead. Bracket may lead introduced by the compensator reaches the maximum is. See, by the concept I have told, you should be able to solve it. Come on, everyone, try to give me the answer for this. Yes, Sartha, correct. Girish, Ryan, correct. Pritam, Ram Prasad, Rahul, Likhita, Shubham, correct. Okay, only thing is you have to identify. Yes, Billa, correct answer. Shiva Shankar, Payal, correct answer. Sandeep, Bhagwati. What are the poles and zeros of this function? Okay, what are the poles and zeros of this function? Let me write down the zeros first. Zeros will be S equal to minus 0.1 and minus 100, and poles of the function will be S equal to minus 1 and minus 10, minus 1 and minus 10 on equating the numerators and denominators to 0. So you have the type of configuration coming up in front of you as, first of all, the lowest is the 0. Minus 0.1, then a pole at minus 1, a pole at minus 10, and a 0 at minus 100, and that is the ZPPZ. ZPPZ. Z being most dominant, and Z being most dominant, matlab it is the lead lag. Okay. Z being the most dominant. Okay. And if Z is the most dominant, you know how the plots will be. How the phase plot, only they are interested in the maximum phase lead. Okay, so how the phase plot will be if the Z is more dominant. If the Z is more dominant, so first you will have what? First you will have positive phase shift, reaches a maximum. Then the pole comes, which pulls the backs to negative. Another pole, which pulls it more negative. And then comes a zero, which raises the phase and then gradually stops at zero. Starts with zero, stops at zero. So what are the frequencies? Sabse pehle, point 1 is due to 0. Then you have the next corner frequency, that is 1 due to a pole, Z, P. Then again a pole at 10th, this is also a P. And then comes the corner frequency, that is due to the 0, that is 100. Maximum phase length, we are interested in this portion, and this occurs for 0.1 less than omega less than 1. That is your region of interest, where the maximum phase lead introduced by the system is maximum, 0.121, option A. I can also put a question like this. Listen, if you have understood this question, can you answer this, guys? What is the frequency range such that the phase lag introduced is maximum? Phase lag introduced is maximum. See, again, the word is maximum, but lag obviously means negative values of phase. Negative values of phase. Okay. So, the other point. It would be this point, actually. Let me just write down this one. This will be known as maximum phase lag because it is in negative, and the above one is actually the maximum phase lead. Okay, so maximum phase lag occurs in the frequency range 10 to 100. The answer is 10 less than omega less than 100 is the answer. That means option number C would go in that case. So just see whether it is, you know, maximum to bol rahe, but you also have to read the question whether they are telling lead or lag. Lead obviously positive and lag obviously means negative phase, lagging phase. Okay. Screenshot for this question. So I have created two questions for this. Screenshot for this. Next one. Next screenshot. Next question, guys. The pole zero configuration. The pole zero configuration of a compensator. See, there's definitely some diagram mistake here. This axis, J omega axis, as seen, there's no pole at origin. They have shown the pole at origin. There is no pole at origin as seen. So there is some correction in the diagram, obviously. This should be your J omega axis. This should be your J omega axis. And I will try to eliminate this as far as possible. So within the class, very carefully, I can use the white pen and do the corrections. That's good. Okay. Yeah. So it is understood there is no pole at origin. I'm just making the question clear for you. Pole is more dominant. The pole is more dominant. Okay. The pole is most dominant. Okay, so that is PZZP. That means lead lag. Sorry, lag lead. Pole more dominant, the lag lead. Pole is the most dominant, the lag lead. Okay. Option number B. It's a simple question. Lag lead. Even this is not required, guys. Pole most dominant, obviously we know it is going to be this. I have already told you this general magnitude plot for lead lag and lag lead both. Okay, option number B. Next question. Next question, ESC 16. Lead compensator decreases the bandwidth? No. लीड कंपनसेटर में हमने देखा था दैट ओमेगा जी इंक्रीजेस, सो बैंडविथ आल्सो इंक्रीजेस इन द लीड कंपनसेटर. ओके, इन द लैग कंपनसेटर सेकेंड वन वी सॉ दैट omega g decreases, so the bandwidth also decreases. So which of them is true? Lead compensator se bandwidth decrease hoga? No, that is false. Lag se bandwidth increase hoga? That is also false. So both one and true are, which of them is correct? Neither one nor two. Option number D. Which of them is correct? Neither one nor two. Both are not correct actually. Reverse given. Lead compensator will increase the bandwidth and lag compensator will actually decrease the bandwidth. Here it is given opposite. Okay. Just a factual question. Tick mark. So, like yesterday's class, I again tell you that remember the conclusions which I have told for lead as well as lag. Remember the conclusions for both. Next question now. The open loop transfer function of a plant is 1 upon S square minus 1. If the plant is operated in unity feedback configuration, then the lead compensator that can stabilize this control system. The open loop transfer function of a plant is GS equal to 1 upon S square minus 1. And if the plant is operated in unity feedback, then the lead compensator. You must know where you will be introducing the lead compensator. Okay. First of all, what is the block diagram that should come like? See, GS is given to you. Yes. Shubham only correct till this time. No guys, no. Nah. Big mistake is happening here. First listen. See, this is GS. So, where will you connect the compensator first of all? Compensator GCS will be connected in cascade with GS. And then the system is connected in unity negative feedback. Here comes my summing point. This is my input R. Unity negative feedback. This is the output C. Okay. A is definitely not correct. Okay. Exactly, Zishan. A is definitely not correct. Okay. This is RHP 0. It has a RHP 0. And first of all, it is not a lead compensator. Option number B. Mein pole is closer to the origin. So this is a lag compensator. Okay. Why it is not option number A? Why it is not a lead compensator? Because it has RHP 0. I told both an R, both pole and 0 must be in LHP. Option number B is not a lead compensator. Question mein pucha hai, which of the lead compensator can stabilize? Okay. The first select a lead compensator and then see which of the lead compensator can stabilize. Dono ko dekhna hai. Stability, lead compensator both. You have to stabilize the system only by using the lead compensator. Not by any other thing. Maybe option number A se wo stable ho raha ho. I agree. Chaliye, maybe. But still that is not the correct answer because that is not a lead compensator. Which of the lead compensator can stabilize? So only option number C or D is left. So if I go with C. If I just go with option number C, what is my characteristic equation? That will be HS to 1 and 1 plus GCS into GS equal to 0. So 1 plus GCS, what is the option number C? 10S plus 2. Both of these are lead. See, dono ka pole 0 configuration same as 0 at minus 2, pole at minus 10. Both of them are lead. Itna confirm kar dete hain. Yeah, it would cancel S minus 1. Okay, but the given transfer function GCS, that itself is not lead compensator. Okay, Yashwant and Zion. So with respect to stability, it may be okay, but not with respect to the lead compensator. 1 upon 10 S plus 2 upon S plus 10 into 1 upon S square minus 1 equal to 0. So what is my characteristic equation? S into S square S cube minus S plus 10 S square minus 10 plus 10s plus 20 equal to 0. So I get s cube plus 10s square plus 10s minus s. So it is plus 9s and then minus 10 plus 20 plus 10 equal to 0. See, it is the characteristic equation. Okay. So whether the system is stable or not, This is just the lead compensator used. Whether it is stable or not, go for Routh-Hurwitz. S cubed, S square. 1 and 9, 10 and 10. So S raised to the power 1. 10, 9, 90, 90 minus 10, 80. 80 by 10 is 8, 0. S raised to the power 0, 8 into 10 divided by 10 is just equal to 8. This is 0. Okay. So by looking into the first column, of the Routh array, it is pretty much clear that there is no RHP root because no sign change. So the system is stable. No RHP root, no J omega root. J omega to tab aata hai na when there is a auxiliary equation. So no RHP roots or no J omega roots. So the system is purely stable. Okay, the system is purely stable. Correct everyone? 10, 10, मैंने कहाँ मिस किया? 10 ही तो लिखा है, just a second. हाँ, that is 10, kind, correct. Got it, got it. Got your points, guys. 10, correct. Alright, so if, now, सबसे पहला observation, सबसे first thing, if one of the option matches in gate, only one option can be correct. ठीक है, तो for if you are solving it in exam, no need to go for the option number D. Only one of the option can be correct. Now Yugandhar, alpha is not greater than one. This is not the standard form. By the way. और मैंने आपको क्या बोला था कि अल्फा इज जस्ट अ कांस्टेंट दैट कैन बी मैनेज्ड. आपको इसको कैसे अरेंज करना है? 10 इनटू 2 1 प्लस s बाय 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 10 1 प्लस s बाय 10. ठीक है, तो इट इज इक्वल टू 2 1 प्लस s बाय 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस s बाय 10. ओके, सो नाउ युगंधर यू हैव टू कंपेयर दैट t इज इक्वल टू हाफ. And 1 upon 10 is alpha into t, alpha into half. So from there you get alpha equal to 1 by 5. Alpha equal to 1 by 5, which is less than 1. That will always be less than 1. Then only it is lead. Okay. And what about this constant? I told this constant can be multiplied by any other thing. That can be nullified. Don't worry about this. Alpha aapko actually yahan se find out karna hai. This should be t and this should be alpha t. Here this point we have to calculate alpha. Okay. Okay, Yugandhar and others as well. 1 plus st upon 1 plus s alpha t. Main comparison yahan se hona chahiye aapka. Okay, yeah. So, option number C, only one of the option is correct. But still, if you want, we can check the other one, not a big deal. We can check the other one. If I go with option number D, I will have the characteristic equation 1 plus twice s plus 2 upon s plus 10 into 1 upon s square minus 1 equal to 0. So it will be s cube minus s plus 10 s square minus 10 plus 2 s plus 4 equal to 0. S cube plus 10 s square plus s minus 6. I think yehi aa raha hai. Okay, twice s plus 2 tha na? Twice s plus 2 upon s plus 10. Correct. Okay, so s cube minus s plus 10 s square minus 10 plus 2 s plus 4 equal to 0. This itself confirms that the system is not stable. All the coefficients must be of the same sign. That is why I told you, you can stop at option number C. Okay guys, screenshot for this question quickly. It's number one. Even if one of the option is correct, match it and go for the next question. More than one option cannot be correct anyways. Screenshots quickly. Next one. Next one, I'll hide my view for this. Option number C, ensure stability. Yes, exactly, Yashwant, we have converted a marginally stable system into a pure stable system, and that is why compensators are there, to improve the stability of a system. To improve the stability of a system. Actually, 1 upon s square minus 1, I think that will be purely unstable only. Two roots at origin. Two roots of characteristic equation at origin. That will be purely unstable only. Okay. Not marginally stable also. All right, guys, so that's it for the compensators. And again, I repeat, compensators with respect to MCQ questions, if I say compensators are actually very scoring in nature, the questions, as you have seen, and I've covered almost all variety asked in the competitive exam. Okay. No, Zion, that is the roots of only GS. I'm talking about characteristic equation. Na? Characteristic equation kaisa banega? 1 upon 1 plus 1 by s square minus 1 equal to 0. I'm talking about characteristic equation. This is the GS given without any compensator. So this is leading to s square equal to 0. Okay. S square equal to 0. Okay. So two poles at origin. All right. Okay, guys. So tomorrow we're going to start with one important chapter. One important chapter tomorrow, that is Thursday. Last one, very important for GATE, okay, and that is at 4 p.m. we start with the state space analysis, class number 1, and first we are going to talk about state space models, the state space models, okay, and there are, in this chapter, it's very interesting, there are so many tricks that is going to work out, so interesting to solve the questions by tricks, so many tricks are applicable, you know, some matrices will come into picture, some eigenvalues again will come into picture, as we have learned eigenvalues in the mathematics, they'll come here in some sense, eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So we shall start studying the state space analysis tomorrow at 4 p.m. That's it for the compensators class. And it's again, I repeat, it's question point of view, very scoring topic. Okay, very scoring topic. All right. Saurav, I haven't received any such doubt in my doubt box. Maybe you have sent it to the general doubt box. Okay, please tag me. Revise inverse Laplace for state space analysis. No, only basics. Only basic function. E power minus t, t e power minus t, sine t, cos t. Just the basics. You are talking in terms of state transition matrix, I think. Okay, Laplace inverse of SI minus A whole inverse. Okay, Laplace inverse of SI minus A whole inverse. Okay, you can tag it at the rate Rakesh Selvage. I think that is how students tag it. So no hardcore revision of inverse, and that will come towards a state transition matrix. Baad mein aayega. Tomorrow we'll first see the state space model, controllable form, you know, observable form, canonical forms, diagonal forms. All these forms will be seen. All right. Chaliye. Okay. So we'll start tomorrow state space analysis. Bye bye. Take care. See you tomorrow at 4 p.m. Very important. Don't miss this. Very important chapter for GATE. Bye bye. Take care.